Hey guys, I'm Mo and I'm very excited to be doing this step-by-step tutorial for React Native. If you found this video, you probably know what React Native is. I mean, otherwise you've ended up with Objective-C or Swift tutorials for iOS or Java tutorials for Android or whatever. So I assume that you know what React is and you know JavaScript and ES6. You don't have to master React and ES6, you only need to know generally what the concepts are. So, if you have used React for web before, essentially you were using React DOM. React DOM and React were split since version 0.14. That being said, as mentioned in the release announcement, the essence of React has nothing to do with browsers or the DOM. They basically did this to make it easier to have more environments that React can render to. In this series, we're gonna build an app for GitHub using React Native, and all my code will be in a GitHub repo in this whole series. Now, let's get started. First, we need to install React Native CLI, and for that we're going to use npm, and we need to install it globally. This is a tool that helps us create a new React Native project, and I'm going to use this command React Native init as the name of our app. For this tutorial, our app name will be GitHub app. This process might take a few minutes to finish, so don't worry if it's taking too long. Mine is now almost finished, and yeah. You can see that it created a new folder, and we're gonna start off in this folder. Now I'm gonna open it in my editor. And that was GitHub app. And yes, this is my project. So you can see that there are two files here, index.android and index.ios. These are the entry points for each platform. It means that index.ios.js will only run on iOS and index.android.js will only run on Android. This .android. and .ios. Specifies that this file should only run on the corresponding platform. So I'm gonna look at this file. You can see there is a template here that was generated by React Native CLI. Now let's see how this app will look like on an actual device. So I'm gonna use Xcode for simulating an iOS device. So you'll need to open this directory and go inside the iOS directory. There's an Xcode project file here. I'm gonna open it. And I can specify the device of my choice here. I'm gonna choose iPhone 6. And you have to hit this button. This will build your project and it opens a new terminal window. That's basically the packager. This is the app, this is a Node.js app that creates the JS bundle that will communicate with your app. And there is this app which contains native codes that can understand this JS bundle and render the view on the screen. You can see it's loading the bundle. Alright, this is our app, and it says for reloading, press Command and R. For opening the menu, the dev menu, press Command and D. And I do Command D, and this is the development menu. Okay, let's change something to see how everything changes after saving this. I'm gonna say hello here, and I'll do Command R. Now you can see the changes. There was no need to rebuilding the project to see the changes, so it works easily and it just gets the new bundle, the new JS bundle from the packager, this packager, to impose the changes. Now let's create a splash screen for our app. For that, I'm going to create a new file called splash.js that will contain a React component. Let's do this imports that are required for React component. I'm gonna export this component, export default class splash extends component, and we're gonna render something like a text. Let's see if it works. Hello world. Let's see what happens if we reload it. Nothing happens because we haven't used it yet. So I'm gonna import it first. Import splash from splash. And I'm gonna replace this element with a new instance of this splash component. I'm gonna reload it now. And you can see that it says a valid React element must be returned. So it basically means that this text is not a valid element for React Native. So I'm going to import something called view from React Native. And I'm going to create a new instance of this and component. Let's see what happens. We see a blank screen because this view element contains nothing. Now let's see if I can write hello world here. Now I can't. It says that hello world must be wrapped in an explicit text component. So I'm gonna import this text component from React Native. I'm gonna wrap this inside this text. This component is used for displaying text. Yes, it worked. You can see that it is underneath this status bar. So let's see. Let's do some styles on our view component. You can use this style prop. You can pass an object, like what we do in HTML and CSS. So I'm gonna say that I want some red background. Yeah, it worked. So you can see that it's not filling the screen. So for that, we can use Flexbox. This React Native Flexbox is almost the same with what we have in CSS3. So for that, I'm gonna say flex one. You can see that it worked, but my text is still sticking on the top of the page. So I'm gonna make it vertically center aligned using this justify content property, and I'm gonna set it as center. Cool. Now let's do it horizontally too. And for that, I'm gonna use align items center. Good. You might have noticed that this way of writing styles is not very clean. So we can create a new object and we can store all the styles there. So I'm gonna say const styles equal to this object. I'm gonna call this wrapper. So we can mimic something like class names that we have in HTML and CSS. Alright, I'm gonna use this styles wrapper. Let's see what happens. Yeah, it's still the same. It worked. But the thing is, every time that an instance of this component is created, these objects are passed to the native side. But React Native comes with something called StyleShield. With the help of StyleShields, you can pass the objects once, and after that, it will only deal with some references called IDs. For the first time that you run this create function, it returns an object with the same keys, but their values are IDs instead of these style objects. And those IDs are the references to those styles on the native side. So it's better for performance to use this style sheet. And it's still working. Okay, I'm gonna add a new text here. Powered by React Native. Okay, I'm gonna make this text white. So I'm gonna call it title, color white. Yeah, it's working. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger. Font size would be 35. Good. Font weight can be bold. You can see that it's very similar to CSS. And also for this powered by, I'm gonna call it subtitle. I'm gonna make it white. And I'm gonna make it lighter. So styles.subtitle. Oh, sorry. That should be 200. Now I've got my powered by React Native stuck to the bottom of the page. So I'm gonna wrap these text elements inside a view. No difference, still it's the same. Now I'm gonna add some styles to see the space that this view element is occupying. So I'm gonna call this styles.title wrapper and I'm gonna add this style. I'm gonna give it a green background. Now you can see that this view is bound here. Now what we actually want to do is adding flex one to make it feel its parent. Yeah, and it worked. Now we can see my powered by React Native is sticking to the bottom. Now I'm gonna remove the background color. And I need it to be center aligned, so I'm gonna do just the content center. Yeah, it's what I was expecting. And now I'm gonna add a fancy color to the background. So I use this flat UI colors website. This color is good. I'm gonna change this red color with this green one. Yeah, it looks nice. Let's replace this hello world with GitHub app. Now we'll add some padding to this powered by React Native. So I say padding button 20. There you go, guys. That was pretty much it. If you have any questions or comments, leave it in the comment section below. Till next time.